The congressional races for us very closely. And Jeff, you've got some new numbers in?
Well, data numbers, that seems to be the big buzzwords in many sectors, and it is in politics, too. You definitely can learn a lot from them. So I started breaking down the results by counties, and they paint very interesting pictures. So let's start with the 24th congressional district in 2016. Here it is right here. Republican John Katko took every single county right here, Onondaga, Cayuga, Wayne, and that western part of Oswego County. That's why it's all red there. Some of them he captured pretty easily, like Onondaga County with a 30,000 vote advantage over Colleen Deacon there. Now, let's switch this to this year. And you can see some blue pop up on this map. Onondaga County flips from red to blue, and Dana Balter has nearly an 18, almost 1,900 vote advantage there. That's a pretty massive swing from a 30,000 vote advantage for John Katko to now being down by almost 1,900. And that might be why this race was a lot closer than 2 years ago, and maybe much closer than many thought. Now to the 22nd. Another interesting picture there. We can see Claudia Tenney right here grabbing a lot of the votes in 2016. Obviously, she won that race, her first one. But we can also maybe see where she lost her seat. So 2 years ago, Tenney wins all but Cortland and parts of Broome County, and that's where Kim Myers was from, her Democratic challenger then. Now, look at Oneida County right here, all red, right, with a 10,000 vote advantage for Claudia Tenney. Now, let's go to last night. And here's the breakdown now of the map. Still, Broome and Cortland go to the Democrat, but look at Oneida County. Now has flipped to blue. Brindisi right now with almost a 1,000 vote lead. That's a nearly 11,000 vote flip in 2 years and may be key to what appears to be a victory for Anthony Brindisi. And one of the 28 seats that Democrats appear to have picked up across the country as the balance of power in the House of Representatives in Washington, D.C., switches back to the Democrats, right now standing at 223 to 201. They only needed 23 to get that power back. It's the first time they've had it since 2010. And Christie, also a change of power in the New York State Senate, where the Democrats have locked up control there, although I guess no changes here party-wise in Onondaga County, right?
That is right, Jeff. In the 50th State Senate District in Central New York, it is a Republican declaring victory in the race. Bob Antonacci, the Onondaga County Controller, ran against Democratic candidate John Mannion. Claiming victory last night, Antonacci says working with a Democratic-controlled state Senate will come down to talking about the issues that people are facing in the area. Antonacci leading Mannion by about 2,800 votes, but Mannion says he's not giving up yet and will let the absentee ballots play out. In the 53rd state Senate race, progressive Rachel May won the seat. She beat out longtime incumbent Dave Valesky in a Democratic primary this September. Valesky had been a part of the New York Independent Democratic Caucus that worked with Republicans in the state Senate. Another change of power, the state Senate now easily in the hands of the Democrats. The New York Times reporting Democrats won 8 of the Republican-held seats. The Democrats now with a commanding majority with new power to push through their agenda without needing to rely on Republican support. For full coverage,